State Farmers. Now let's have some smiles, guys. It's all over here. Come on, Jason. Come on.
Take another one.
Okay.
Come on. Let's go, boys.
Says it's worth filming.
Nah, it's not bad.
So what?
Yet I've seen you want to raise a helping hand for everyone. Thank you, Grandpa. We all love you. For my family, and any family, to serve others so diligently and unconditionally for so long, what is the secret to having a caring and serving family with a bond that is unbreakable? If you know the answer, God bless you. If you don't, well, God bless you too. Because He gave us all the ability to learn at any age. And the secret ingredients in the roots of my family tree are no secret at all. Faith, hope, and love. Faith for our family's devotion, hope for our family's future, and love for our family's God. And ladies and gentlemen, those three right there, those are the true basics of life right there. Those are the basics. I stand before all of you today asking you not to take your family for granted. If you hold those close to you, close to your heart, you also can raise a trophy high, claim yourself a winner, because your family has blessed your life. To my family, thank you. To my mother, Annette Lava, especially, and my father, Jerry Lava, and my brother, Lance Lava. At times we swayed from the basics of life. At times we tried to stand alone. But I hope that we always remember to look to each other for guidance and ask forgiveness from one another in the hard times and the good. There's a trophy in my heart for you. Should not perish, but his everlasting life. Now the just shall live by faith. We may rejoice and be glad all our days. God is love. Anymore. Everything that needs to be said has already been written in the Word, and the basics of life all start from that one place. Ladies and gentlemen, I stand before you today for the last time, asking you to forever remember and keep this in your heart. Service to others and service to the Lord are one and the same. It is the most fulfilling and important responsibility anyone could possess. If you keep your vision locked on service, you can raise a trophy high and claim yourself because the Lord has blessed your life. To my God, thank you. All the trophies in my heart are for you. Ladies and gentlemen, remember, please, it's never too late to learn the basics of life. Once you learn them, you will never, ever take for granted your trophies of the heart. Thank you.
With a faith born not of words, but of deeds. Achievements won by the present and past generations of agriculturalists in the promise of better days through better ways, even as the better things we now enjoy have come to us through the struggles of former years. This is a question that many farmers are asking. But is it a fair question? For years, farmers were envied throughout the world. They were admired for their advanced technology and its practical use. Nowhere else can 3% of the people feed the rest of the population. Today, one of the largest problems that looms on the horizon for pork producers is their own society's perception of how animals are treated on the family farm.
The family farm, the nation, one of the only nations that not only gives us, but demands in our Constitution the right to free choices. One of these choices is to be or not to be an animal rightist. At one time in America, the family farm was a common sight.
They've been at this for a while. And all these four of these folks here do a real good job of showing lambs. Just a real good job. I've asked them all questions, and none of them missed any of the questions. I don't know. There's one lamb out here that's showing a little better for the girl. I don't know if he's been worked with a little bit more, but this lamb is really showing good. He showed good in class, and he's showing good now, and this will be this lamb right here. This lady right here will be a champion showman.
Senior champion showmanship is Shelly Hendricks.
Oh God, I'm fine. Hey. Here it goes, have a doggy biscuit. Stop this, Brian.
Let me, just a minute.
Not yet, don't stop it yet. No,
baby.
Okay, now you can stop it.
Wait a minute. Let me see if I can
kind of
figure out how these boys did.
Give that to me. Is it still going? Squint over you, Mr. Burns, real quick. So, Mr. Burns, what are your basic feelings right now?
Pretty tough, Ryan. Pretty tough.
Pretty tough. You got anything to say?
No go karts.
No go karts?
They're not open during the day.
Well, a doggy biscuit.
Turn.
Hey, back behind you.
Turn.
Hey.
What are y'all looking at, anyway?
Yeah, no kidding.
What are we doing here, dude? You're.
No,
stop. Oh, are you gonna knock me down? Okay.
God. Yeah, we're gonna see him.
Yeah, you dang straight we is.
Right there.
Oh no.
Oh, she's kind of big.
Find another one.
fell off. Hey, the deal's still blinking.
Yeah, I know. You might want to shut that bad boy off for just a minute.
What's
that?
We have no good footage right now.
Yeah, we can just...
Hey, where you going, Mr. Burns?
Just a minute.
You're getting me dizzy.
Ooh.
Okay. Whoa.
Okay.
If you would quit wasting gasoline, you could be using it like right here.
Hey, turn
it around.
Whoa. Would you chill out, please?
Fun.
Slow. We don't have anything else to record.
What?
Hey, we want to get him to a...
Oh,
still go. Wait, we want to get him.
Hi, y'all.
There they go.
Him and like him, lamb, bigger frame, longer body, pounds heavier, higher performing lamb, but also he was a heavier muscled lamb that simply was square behind his shoulders, got progressively thicker down his top, and handled with more plump and bulge to his lower leg. When sent to the rail, he'll rail a pounds heavier carcass with more total pounds of loin and leg. I acknowledge that the one lamb was a neater package lamb that was neater about his head, neck, and shoulders, and was had more look about him when viewed from the side, but I fault him and like him second today, as he lacked the total amount of width and dimension down his top, and liked it and was flatter throughout his lower leg.
The biggest volume, highest performing gilt of the class in four, I preferred over two in my initial pair. Again, four is a bigger volume gilt that had more width between the blades, was wider to her chest floor, and had more width and expandability through her thoracic cavity. Furthermore, she was a higher performing gilt that was heavier muscled and heavier weight. Therefore, four offered the most replacement potential of any gilt of the class.
Yes. For a 1-2-4, for the packer's preference for a trim carcass without giving up muscle composition, I prefer the 3U, as he was the best combination, best balanced lamb in this class today. In my initial duo, 3-1, I preferred 3. 3 was a longer pattern, bigger frame, heavier weight lamb that was correctly finished. She was a firmer, nicer handling lamb behind the shoulder, over her rib, and down her top. When sent to the rail, she would rail a more desirable, more productive carcass with no more total pounds of a high price.
Although if I could change her, I would like to clean her up in her lower one third. In reference to my top pair of coarse haired gilts, I prefer 4-2, as 4 was a larger frame, longer body, more skeletally extended gilt that was a more maternal appearing gilt.
Beneath the stars above, for a moment all the world was right. How could I have known that you'd ever say goodbye? And now I'm glad I didn't know the way it all would end. Could have missed the pain, but I'd have had to miss the dance. Holding you, I held everything for a moment. Wasn't I the king? If I'd only know how the king would fall, hey, who's to say? You know I might have changed it all. And now I'm glad I didn't know the way it all would end, the way it all would go. Our lives are better left to change. just the pain that I'd have had to miss the dance. It's my life, it's better left to chance. I could have missed the pain, but I'd have had to miss the river, ever changing as it flows, and the dreamer's just a vessel that must follow where it goes, trying to learn from what's behind you, and never knowing what's in store, makes each day a constant battle, just to stay between the shores. And I will sail my vessel till the river runs dry, like a bird upon the wind. These waters are my sky. I'll never reach my destination if I never try. So I will sail my vessel till the river runs dry. Too many times we stand aside and let the water slip away, to what we put off till tomorrow has now become today. So don't you sit upon the shoreline and say you're satisfied. Choose to chance the rapids and dare to dance the tide. Yes, I will sail my vessel till the river runs dry, like a bird upon the wind. These waters are my sky. I'll never reach my destination if I never try. So I will sail my vessel till the river runs dry. There's bound to be rough waters, and I know I'll take some falls. With the good Lord as my captain, I can make it through them all. Yes, I will sail my vessel till the river runs dry, like a bird upon the wind. These waters are my sky. I'll never reach my destination if I never try. So I will sail my vessel till the river runs dry. Yes, I will sail my vessel till the river runs dry. Till the river runs dry.